Since being introduced in Mastercam 2020, 3D HST Blend has become an integral toolpath for workpiece finishing. Several new additions have arrived for Mastercam 2022 that further the capabilities of this already flexible path. Let's take a look. I have a blow mold here that I'm applying finishing paths to. I'll launch a blend toolpath and select the light green surfaces as my drive surfaces, and also zero out my wall and floor stock with the Reset Stock Values button. Next, I'll have to choose the curves to blend between. With 3D HST Blend, the most common use scenario is selection of two open chains to blend between, but we can also use closed contours and even points as input curves, which is what we'll show now. I'll select this outer wireframe loop as my first curve, and then select this wireframe point in the center of the cavity as my second curve, then end selection. In cut parameters, I'll set my step over to 1 mm, my projection type to 3D to properly calculate across the fillet walls, and change my blend distance to 0.5 mm to make sure my pattern density is high enough to produce a smooth blend. For cut method, I'll select one way. In my linking parameters, I'll disable secondary leads and set primary leads to simple 2 mm vertical arcs, then click OK to finish up and generate my toolpath. I get a nice result here, with my passes slowly blending between the outer loop and the inner point, with a true 3D step over on the fillet areas. One area I might want to improve is these transitions between passes. On a mold pocket like this, I want the tool to maintain a constant engagement, and I definitely don't want to see those transition lines in the finished surface of the part. Let's go back into parameters and enable a new cutting method in 3D HST Blend for Mastercam 2022, Spiral. I'll click OK and regenerate. Now I have a single continuous 3D step over spiral from the outer contour to the inner point with no lifts or transitions, which is a really nice way to finish this pocket. Let's take a look at a modified mold design on level 22 and examine another application of 3D HST Blend. Here, I've got an interrupted pocket area that I'd like to cut with a blend between the two wireframe lines we see outside the pocket here. Remember that blend doesn't require the blend curves to be directly on the surface you're cutting to generate a cut pattern. Let's launch into a new blend path. I'll select my pink surfaces as machining geometry, again zeroing out stock to leave values. In toolpath control, I'll go and select the two wireframe lines as my blend curves. One more thing I'll do here is enable silhouette boundary for my containment. I'm doing this because I'd like to keep the tool from rolling over the sharp edges around the pocket as it tries to follow the full extents of the blend curves. This is a quick and effective way to trim the extraneous tool motion from this path. If I was cutting surfaces that were closer to vertical in respect to the tool plane, I could also change to Tool Contact Point Contain here to better trim to the exact contact extent for each pass. Since my surfaces are mostly square to the tool plane, I'll skip this step. For cut pattern, I'll use a one-way method and a 2D blend projection. Let's go ahead and click OK to finish up and generate. I've gotten my one-way blended passes that I was envisioning, but looking at the rapid moves here, I can see that the tool is jumping around between these two regions fairly often, which is adding a lot of cycle time. I'll go back into cut parameters and look at the last blend enhancement to 2022 to fix this. Under cut style, I have a checkbox to optimize cut order. Clicking that and regenerating, we now see that we're intelligently reordering the passes to machine by region and greatly reduce the rapid travel distance. These expanded choices in 3D HST Blend open up new finishing possibilities for your workpiece in Mastercam 2022.